Welcome back to the channel, guys. Welcome back to 25 Cocktails to Christmas and yet another lovely tipple today for you. So let's see what it's on the list. So here we are, few days left, and I'm coming with a recipe of mine, which it's called Santa Nightcap. Yes, we don't know if Santa enjoying things like that, but who knows? At least we can enjoy. So this is a wonderful cocktail. Again, it's based on gin. So for everybody who likes gin, that's a good news. Two options here with the gin before I start making the cocktail. Originally, I created the recipe with sloe gin, but recently I tried with a new favorite of mine, which is the sour cherry from Luxardo, and I really like it. So today we're making it with the sour cherry. However, remember, if it's not available to you and you can have any or you can find any sloe gin, which I'm pretty sure you will because it's available worldwide, try with the sloe gin. It's wonderful. Not any other gin, okay? Sloe gin or a sour cherry. It needs to be with this lovely berry cherry flavor, okay? How I put it together. Sloe gin, berry, sour cherry, cherry. Anyway, whatever. Let's don't get too excited, but let's make this cocktail because it's a wonderful sip. It's a lovely, refreshing cocktail, and you can have it any time of the day, of the evening, after, before meal, whatever you decide. It's a wonderful party drink. So let's make it. Okay, as I mentioned, you can absolutely replace the sour cherry gin with a sloe gin because originally I created a recipe with a sloe gin. But if you find the sour cherry by Luxardo, I strongly recommend you try this wonderful gin. So, first, we have 30 ml of the sour cherry gin or sloe gin, okay? Wonderful. Then, we have tawny port or a vintage port, 20 ml of the port, go into your shaker. I use grams. This is a vintage port, but if you find tawny port or any aged port, 10 years old, it'll be fantastic. However, once again, as I always mention, use the port which you have. It's absolutely fine. Then next ingredients, it's 20 ml of Cointreau, the lovely old Cointreau orange liqueur, which is unreplaceable, to be honest, in some cocktails and in many recipes. And strangely enough, I've not done many recipes with Cointreau. I don't know why, but we'll change that. Okay? Then we go to modifiers. First modifier, it's a cranberry syrup. 20 ml of cranberry syrup. You can make your own at home from dry cranberries, or if you have fresh, you can create your own syrup. It's basically simple syrup with the cranberries. Simple as that, or you can just buy ready one. And the final two ingredients, just a little touch, like a dash of maple syrup. That's it, to bring some sweetness. And of course, a little dash of gingerbread syrup. And this is it. We are ready to shake before we put our last ingredient, but we'll go to this after. So, ice in the shaker. You don't need much ice, you need to give them just a quick shake, just to cool down, to chill the cocktail. Don't need too much dilution because it's served over ice. So let's shake. Beautiful. And there we have it. Now the cocktail is ready. Grab your glass. We're gonna strain it, doesn't need double strain because it's surf over ice, as I mentioned, so it's not big deal. Just fill up your glass with ice. Pour your cocktail. This look wonderful, dark red color. And depends of the glass which you serve. Now here it's another thing which you can adjust. If you like to be a more kind of a long drink and more diluted and not that strong, you can serve in a tall highball so you have more space. If you like to feel more the spirits and the flavors of the port and the Cointreau and the gin and all these things, you can serve in a small glass like this, over ice, And all you need to do is just top it up with a cranberry juice. So it's up to you guys, whatever you like. I do like more to be on the side of feeling the spirits inside. So I just top up with a little bit of cranberry juice. But if you want in the long glass, feel free, put in the long glass, put more cranberry juice. Absolutely fine. And finally, guys, you can garnish it with anything you desire, okay? Originally, it doesn't need any garnish, but if you decide you want to pop a, just, you know, for a aesthetic, you can put any garnish. So, for example, I will use dehydrated lime. I will just pop it in. And on the top, I'm gonna put dehydrated apple. Simple as that. However, you can put dehydrated orange, or you can put fresh fruit, or even fresh apple. It's absolutely fine. And a little straw, and there you have it. My little Santa Nightcap, which is absolutely delicious. So let's give it a try. Oh yes, wonderful sweet, with little bit of tart from the cranberry. So if you make it a more longer drink, it's gonna be more dry. But I like, as I mentioned, with a little bit of cranberry, just to have this kind of a festive feel, because we already have the cranberry syrup inside, so it's gonna be very rich on cranberries, okay? But then you get the sweetness from the maple syrup and from the gingerbread syrup, and it's all pairing fantastically with a lovely sour cherry gin, or in your case, if you don't have it, with a sloe gin, and port and Cointreau work very well in this mix. So guys, once again, cheers! Thank you for watching. If you're new to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. If you kind of feel it and you're not sure, just slide and just click it, okay? Comment, share, and enjoy your Christmas. I'll see you tomorrow with another cocktail. But until then, as always, I love you and I leave you. Bye-bye.